The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Swine flu. What is swine flu? Can you get swine flu? How can you protect yourself from swine flu? What happens when you have a swine flu H1N1 infection, right? So we will cover this topic today. I am Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to my channel. H1N1 influenza is swine flu, which is basically an infection. And it is not the same as the seasonal flu, which is also called influenza, right? This swine flu is a type of virus, which it was called, which was initially found in 2009. And it was found all over the world, but it was called swine flu early on because the test showed that it was like the flu virus that occurred in pigs, in swine. That's why it was thought that it's swine flu, right? So what are the symptoms? What happened when this H1N1 virus infects you? Later on it was found out that this is a different kind of virus, but the name stuck. That's why it's now called H1N1, right? So symptoms, what happens when you get swine flu? First, the symptom will start from 3 to 5 days after you get infected or exposed to the virus, right? And on an average, the symptoms will last around 8 days, and common symptoms will be very similar to those of any other viral infection, like fever, sore throat, cough, there may be headache or muscle aches, chills, sometimes weakness, running or stuffiness in the nose, vomiting, or sometimes even diarrhea, right? You need to get evaluated if there is a swine flu outbreak in your area and you have any of these symptoms, right? See, swine flu by itself is a rare cause of all these symptoms, and there are many more common causes. But if in your area right now swine flu is prevalent, then you have to take care, right? So what can you do? And obviously this problem can occur in babies and children also, right? In small children and babies, they may not tell you about all these symptoms, right? So in them, you have to look for any signs of trouble breathing, fever, which is combined with a rash, any confusion, any impatience, trouble waking up in the morning if they are not drinking enough fluid, if there are any flu-like symptoms which do not go away and then return again and again with a higher fever and cough, then swine flu can be a possibility. So what is the basic reason? Why do you get swine flu? Obviously, swine flu is a virus, H1N1, and it spreads from person to person, right? From another person. You cannot get it by eating pork or pork products. You cannot get it from the swine, all right? Now, how this H1N1 influenza is diagnosed is also very important, right? Your doctor will basically first do a physical examination, review all your symptoms and your history, medical history, and then your doctor will do a rapid flu test, right? There is a test for H1N1, rapid flu, and there are several other tests are done to check for other several viruses or even bacterial infections. The test to only check for H1N1 virus takes a few days to get results, right? That's why your doctor may start you with the treatment empirically right away and will not wait for the result, right? And this is very common wherever there is an H1N1 outbreak in an area, right? Obviously, then there are high chances that you might be, with those symptoms, you might be having the infection. So can you actually prevent H1N1 infection? And how to treat H1N1 infection? So first, let's talk about prevention. Because the best way to avoid H1N1 is prevention. And prevention is done by the flu vaccine, right? There are vaccines, right? Every year a new flu vaccine comes in the market, and CDC, Center of Disease Control and Prevention, recommends that Anyone who is 6 months of age or older should receive a flu vaccine, and people who actually work in a healthcare sector should definitely get vaccinated, and so should someone who is actually living or taking care of children who are younger than 6 months of age. It's important because less than six months you cannot give them, so you need to get yourself, right? Then what kind of vaccine? There are two types of vaccines. One is a trivalent flu vaccine, which basically protects against three most common types of flu. Every season there is a new strain coming up because of viral mutation, and new strain vaccines are coming every year, right? And there are quadrivalent vaccine. Trivalent is three viral against three viruses, including H1N1. And quadrivalent is flu virus, four viruses, anti-vaccine, which protects against four strains. Right, and this is the vaccine which protects you against H1N1, H1N2, and another influenza A, influenza B, both of them. Right, so in general, vaccines are safe, and there is always a chance of infection or reaction whenever you insert a needle. Right, so you need to tell your doctor if something is happening, and you can take vaccine. Don't worry. Then. If you want to prevent getting H1N1, if you see that there is a prevalence in your area, then you need to follow some hygienic principles. Always, always cover your nose and mouth with a tissue when you cough. You never know if you have, you might spread it, right? So if you don't have a tissue, then cough or sneeze into your elbow, right? That is also good. But don't sneeze in your hand. That is not good because you touch your hands. You can do this, right? Sneeze in your elbow. That is a good practice, right? Then you need to put those used tissues in the trash. Don't just throw away anywhere, or don't keep it in your bag or whatever, because that, again, you know, your saliva, your mucus would get spread to those areas also, right? Then wash your hands with soap and water every time you have this kind of sneezing, coughing episodes, or you can just use an alcohol-based hand sanitizer, right? Avoid touching your eyes, nose and mouth, right? Then avoid people who are sick. Avoid a lot of crowded area, because people in the crowd, some of them may have infection, flus, right? And they can spread very easily. Wear a mask if you are traveling and if you are around a large group of people, right? That's protective. Don't share your personal items, right? Don't share your items like makeup, your utensils, your office equipments, your pen, sports personal equipments. If somebody is sick, right? If you feel that they have cold, flu, you might get it back along with your items, right? And so if you get sick, then stay home and work from home and be around people with minimum people, because you need to stay home until at least 24 hours happens after your fever breaks, right? When you don't have fever, then till 24 hours later, you have to stay home, then you can go out, right? So how it is treated? See, obviously, doctor will prescribe antiviral medicines to treat H1N1, right? And these antiviral medicines actually help your immune system to kill the virus, and so that you can recover very fast and you are not contagious anymore. Say, if you have a fever, then you can take a medicine to reduce the fever also, like acetaminophen, paracetamol, Tylenol, or ibuprofen, right? Or naproxen, right? But these drugs can only act on fever or pain, sometimes aches and all, but they don't actually kill the virus, right? So, and you should not give aspirin. Aspirin should not be given to children, teenagers, or even older people, because it can cause bleeding risks, on even risk of Reye syndrome and other syndromes, right? Then you should not drink drink a lot of fluids to stay hydrated and get plenty of rest. Rest and fluids are very important in fluid. This will help your body to fight infections. Then what are the medicines your doctor will give? Your doctor will give antiviral medicines like oseltamivir or zanamivir, right? These are two medicines available. These medicines actually decrease the flu virus activity to reproduce, right? If they don't reproduce, then your body can actually kill them, right? Number one, obviously their number is not increasing. They can actually shorten the time you are sick, right? By reducing your symptoms, they prevent problems such as which are caused by the flu. Complications can be prevented by these medicines, right? So it's important. And these antiviral drugs work best if you take them right when your symptoms begin. So you don't have to wait for the tests to come. Tests will take some days. You should start taking treatment if you have a symptom similar to flu and you have a swine flu prevalence in your area, right? And this form of treatment is more common, right, if you are obviously having any risk of swine flu or its complications. Because see, people who are pregnant, they have a risk of, you know, if pregnant ladies get swine flu, their complication chances will increase. Same thing goes with children, young adults, which are like between 6 months to 24 years of age, or adults who are elder than 65 years of age, right, or older, right? People who are having a severe illness or who are already in the hospital, they have high risk. People who are having weak immune system or any chronic health conditions like asthma or heart disease are also have high risk. So you have to make sure that if these people have any kind of flu symptoms, start them with antiviral medicines, right? See, most people will get infection, will get the virus inside the body, and most people can actually fight off and get rid of H1N1 on their own, on your own immunity, right? You may not need treatment, or even you don't need to go to a hospital or get any this thing also, medicine also. Vaccination will help your immune system get more stronger and get rid of this virus if it comes to you, right? So remember, it's important to get vaccinated. It's important if you have any kind of symptoms which are similar to flu, and during a flu outbreak, go to a doctor, get evaluated, get your medicines, get antiviral treatment. If you have H1N1 confirmed, stay at home until your fever breaks, and then 24 hours later. You cannot get H1N1 from a pig's. Right, so don't worry about that. So H1N1 is a virus. This is all about H1N1, which you need to know, right? So take care, guys. Don't worry about this. It's not such a big problem if you know the facts. So knowledge is the key here, right? Make sure to share this video to everyone. Make sure to ask them to share this video. It's very important. This is Dr. Paramjeet. You're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected, stay healthy. And if you want to contact me, the information is given in the description below. DocWise application, you can download and chat with me like WhatsApp, right? But it's a private chat. So take care, guys. See you. Good night.